Hey everybody, how's it going? This is DQ Tattoos back with another video, and this week I'm going to do things just a little bit different. I'm still going to do a watercolor painting for you, but I decided to go to Walmart and try to find the cheapest watercolor supplies I could get and see if I can make a decent painting using those. So, the stuff I got. Well, I tried to find just a one Sharpie by itself to purchase. I figured that would be cheap enough for this little challenge, but I couldn't find just one Sharpie by itself. Two was the fewest in a pack, and I want to say that was over $3. So instead I went for a two-pack of these Pen Plus Gear brand permanent markers. They're like a generic Walmart brand, I suppose. For two of these, it was 94 cents. So 94 cents for our markers. Went to the kids' art supply aisle and got some Crazy Art washable watercolors. This is an 8-color set that includes a little plastic paintbrush. I'm sure I'm just going to have so much fun using that thing. And then lastly, I tried to find some really cheap watercolor paper. Unfortunately, there was no watercolor paper in the kids' art supply aisle. They had construction paper, there was notebook paper. None of that stuff's going to work very good for watercolor painting. So I went ahead and got some Canson XL watercolor paper. This is a 30 sheet pad, 9 by 12 inches, and I believe this was $5.97 for that. So, I mean, that's a bit more than the markers and the paints, but I didn't really have any other option for that. And you know what? Even though this is a rather cheaper brand of watercolor paper, I actually use it on a regular basis. I typically use the 11 by 15 pads, and I'll cut an inch off of it because most tattoo flash you're going to find is 11 by 14. So now I'll use that for my flash painting videos. I find that it works just fine. You know, as long as I don't go over the same area too much, it won't start falling apart. But generally does pretty good. So I'm going to use some of that, which is a bonus. I get to use some decent paper that I'm used to. Other than that, we will see how it goes. So I'm going to draw a design to paint, and then take a look at these supplies a little bit closer up. We'll see you in a minute. Alrighty, so here are the supplies I picked up. Now obviously I'm going to need a few other things not mentioned here, but they're not really going to be included because most people should have access to them anyways. So you're going to need paper towels. Alright, you're going to need a cup of water. And you're going to need a pencil to draw on your paper, unless you have a light box or something like that, but we'll assume you have a pencil. I think just about anybody can access those three things. Now, other than that, here we go. So here's the paper that I got. It's 300 grams, 140 pounds. That's pretty standard. Again, here is the paper that I normally use for my full-size flash sheets. So same brand, same weight, still 30 sheets, probably a little bit more because it's bigger, 11 by 15, but that's okay. So that is nothing new. All right, got these permanent markers. And they're just generic permanent markers. I think they ended up being 27 cents a piece. You get two of them. And I'm sure, yeah, those work just fine. Actually, they have a bit of a sharper point to them. A lot more fine tip than my normal Sharpie, so that might actually be kind of nice to use. Alright, lastly we have this. This is going to be the most fun part of this little experiment. Let's see, I don't have a knife to open this with. Get this piece of tape off of here. Alright. Take that little paper out. For best results, do not use pre-wash or chlorine bleach. Wash in hot cycle. Repeat if needed. Keep watercolors away from wallpaper, painted walls, furniture, carpeting, and all other materials that cannot be laundered. Okay, so I guess that's washable watercolors. It means it'll wash out of clothes. Oh my. Oh my. I'm not looking forward to using this brush It is terrible. Let's see if I can get a focus on it. Look at this brush. It is frayed and just all over the place. That's what we got. That's part of the challenge. All right, now we definitely have black. I don't know. We got two blacks, it looks like, or unless that's possibly a brown. I don't think it says, and that doesn't say what the colors are anywhere, so we'll just have to test them out and see. But I mean, we got everything we need. We got, looks like, yep. I thought it was two blues. We got a purple, red, orange, yellow, blue, green, black, and whatever that last color is. I don't know. Maybe it's brown. All right, so I'm going to get out a sheet of paper and do a little bit of testing and see how these work. We'll be right back. All right. So, got my water, got my paper towel, got my two permanent markers, got my paints, got my paper. Let's go ahead and tear a sheet of this off of here. Yeah, I don't have a design on here. I'm not actually doing the design part yet. Right now I'm just kind of getting a feel for how terribly amazing these paints are going to be in this brush. Okay, so you know what? When you wet it, it's not super frayed, so that's okay. I hope. All right, so first we have I guess that's supposed to be black. Oh no, this is not going to be fun, I think. look at how thin that is. All right. Next we have green. Wow, that is one bright, I can't talk. It's so amazing, I'm speechless. That is one bright, vibrant green. Next we got some blue. Again, vibrant, bright. Now you're gonna have a hard time finding any muted colors in this palette, I believe. See how bright this yellow is. Neon. It is neon. That is highlighter yellow. I don't think you can probably barely just see it on the camera there. We got some orange. Red, super washed out red. Purple, that is bright. And let's see what this color is. Brown. Okay, so there is a brown. Brown and black look very similar. Alright. So that is our palette. Now, let's see. I think the biggest problem with these is getting a good amount of pigment down. That's why these all look so washed out, is because they are mostly water. Heavily diluted pigment in water. So, if I move my brush around quite a bit here, I'm going to try to pick up as much of that pigment as I can. We will see if that makes a difference. And you know what? It's a little darker. Yeah. That's okay. Not too shabby. Let's see if I can pick up some more. Alright, that's probably about the extent of it. Now, since I don't have a second brush, and these are non-toxic, by the way, let's see if I can shade that out some. that. So the main difference is that you're not just gonna, you're just not gonna get a huge concentration. But I can still get a pretty decent blend going out, you know, and if I want to, I can always layer it. So we're just gonna add some more black there. Build that up a little bit more. I think it's probably about as good as that part is going to get. All right. Trying to line that up. So now you can see the colors we're working with all just so diluted. So watered down, such little pigment. Now you can see here, this is interesting. So that's the black after I first did it. So it's a little bit, again, washed out. Of course, these all are, but when I layered it down, it made it more of a purpley black. So it may just be an issue of just layering these over and over and over again. But here I got a nice blend. It just, to me, it looks like a really, not even a super dark blue, but a pretty dark blue rather than black. So I'm not sure, but you can get what you pay for, so I'm going to see what I can do with these. Alright, so I'm not that sure how well you can see this. Right now I'm just using my iPad as the light table. Obviously the iPad is not a cheap part of the components here, so we're not even talking about that. I do have a light box that I've got. Could use that. But it's kind of big and bulky, so I'd just rather use this. If you're going on the cheap, just draw directly on your paper. And, you know, if you do want to trace it, you can tape your watercolor paper to your paper and then hold it up against the window on a sunny day, and that'll work too. I'm sure there are a lot of other options that you can use to get kind of a light table without having to pay so much for one, but that's just the ones I can think of. So I'm going to go ahead and trace this design using my pen plus gear permanent marker. And then we will get to painting. Alright, now I'm sure you've noticed that this is a lot smaller than the pad of watercolor paper that I was using. All I did was cut a sheet in half. So I took a 12x9 and cut it into a 6x9 and decided to use that anyways. I figured a smaller piece would be a lot better for testing something like this because I'm not quite used to using these supplies and it wouldn't take quite as long for me to do. So I need to refill my water. I'll be right back. We'll get started on the painting. All right. So now I remember from our demonstration that is brown, that is black. That's very important at this point because we always start with the darkest color, or I do, anyways. Sorry, my recording stopped there at some point and I was not paying attention. But as you can see, there's definitely some consistency issues with the black. This whole time, the Blackwell is the only one I've used. And it initially started around like a dark purple.
tone, which you can see here. And as I worked my way down, I went over, did that leaf, then came back over here. And as I started going through these leaves, or petals, it turned more of a greenish color. I'm not really sure why that happened. Maybe it'll change a little bit more once it's drier. But it, I don't know, just something I thought I'd note. It looks cool, I guess. It has a neat effect, but I mean, that's not really what I was going for, so I don't know. But now I'm going to start putting some of the color in.
And here we are with the finished painting. So, you know, I guess it could have been a lot worse. I mean, those paints were definitely a pain to use. They bled really bad into the other colors. You can see where I tried to do some layering, where it started with the black and tried to go over with some orange. That black, even though it was dry, it almost kind of reconstituted itself and bled into the surrounding color. So I guess that's kind of just how these paints work anyways. I mean, you're having to do it with the paint in the well where you're getting it wet, and then it's pulling that pigment into the water. So it makes sense that if you get that pigment wet again on the paper, it's going to pull it out of the paper and into the water again. Now obviously it didn't all bleed everywhere, some of it stayed. But I guess you're going to have that happen a lot more with that kind of paint, because that's just how it's meant to work. So overall, you know, not too bad. I had some fun doing that, and at the end I just decided to kind of make a mess with some splotches and stuff, give the background some more color. And you know what, would I do this again? Probably not. I probably would not use these paints again by choice, you know. I mean, obviously I chose to make this video, I thought it would be fun, but if I wanted to make a good-looking painting, I would not go to these. And that's only because I've got supplies that work great for me that I practice with. If this was all I had, would I continue to paint? Yeah, sure. Why not? You got to work with the tools that you have. And this just goes to show that if you want to get into painting some watercolor paintings, doing some tattoo flash, you don't need much money. Less than $10 will get you started. And yeah, it's going to take a lot more practice using crappier supplies, and they're not going to last all that long, because I mean, there's not a lot of pigment in there. So, hey Jeppy. I think the biggest thing is, if you can, you know, if you want to use these paints, that's fine. They will work, I've proven that. But if you can afford to get some better brushes, definitely do. Definitely get some better brushes. I think that's probably more important than the paint at this point, because the brush that I use there is just terrible. The bristles do not hold their shape, they keep changing. You cannot get some smooth, you can get smooth lines, but it's hard to get the round corners a lot smoother than it is with using some quality brushes. So definitely would recommend, if you're going to go with cheap paint, that's fine, it will work, but get you some better brushes. Some very brushes. And these markers, I'm probably going to start using these instead of Sharpies, because they are a lot cheaper and they work just as good. Permanent markers. you know, of course the paper you use is fine. Just make sure that you're not using computer paper or notebook paper. Paper like that is not absorbent. Watercolor paper is meant to absorb the water and the pigment so it doesn't run everywhere and destroy the paper. It's meant to take a little bit more punishment. So definitely stick with the watercolor paper. But, you know, if you guys are interested in this, I might start picking up different supplies, trying to find some more entry-level watercolor paints, brushes, all that, and doing videos like this to kind of show like a review of those products. So if you're still on the fence about going for the more expensive Dr. P.H. Martin's watercolors, there are a lot of other options out there. So if you want me to show you some of those, I'd be more than happy to keep finding new products and testing them out and showing you what I think. So I hope you liked that video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you know of any friends that might find this video helpful or entertaining, please share it with them. If you want to get updates every week when I post a new video, definitely make sure to subscribe to my channel. Leave a comment. Let me know what you thought of these. Have you tried using supplies like these before? Do you like them? Do you not like them? Are there any other particular products you'd like me to check out as far as watercolor supplies go? Let me know, and maybe I'll check those out and make a new video about it. As always, follow me on Instagram for updates. Post new pictures at least every couple days. I need to get better about that. But I guess that's it for now. Oh, I also need to do the drawing for the winner of last week's painting, which I have right here. So I need to pick the winner for that. I'm going to set up my camera on my computer and do like a random number generator thing so you can see who won.
Alrighty, so I've got everyone's name that has left a comment on my video in a list here, just in the order that they showed up on my page. Now I'm going to randomize this 3 times and we'll have a winner. So here we go. 1, 2, and 3. Alright, so it looks like Ivan Barbosa is our winner. Ivan, if you want to check your messages on here, I will get your address and we'll send you this painting. Everyone make sure to keep checking out my videos in the future because I am going to be doing more of these giveaways. Hopefully going to be reaching 500 subscribers soon, so I'll be doing another giveaway for that. Probably do another one at 1,000 and then I'll just do some more randomly whenever I feel like it. But thanks again for checking out my video. I'll go ahead and post the image so you can see the painting close up, and we'll talk to you next week. Bye.